Alright, the title of my speech is Creating That Family Connection. Okay, so most people, when you ask them how many kids they want, you know, they say 2 to 4, at most you'll get 10. But me personally, I would like 20. Now, I know that that's not feasible, you know, but pretty much what I'm saying is that I want as many as I can get. And the reason that I want so many is because I come from a big family, so I understand the value in it. As I mentioned before, I have 8 brothers and 1 sister. And it's not just my immediate family, also my extended family is also big. I have 20 aunts and uncles, 13 on my dad's side, 7 on my mom's. So even though I have such a big family, I feel like I have a great connection with each and every one of them. The reason I feel like I have such a great connection, I think is there's key factors that I focused on, you know, growing up that my family has, which is traditions, responsibility, and proximity. Now, to help me introduce tradition, I would like to introduce Linda and Richard Iyer, and they're really like big timers in the field of family connections. They've written over 25 books, they're New York Times bestsellers, they've been on Oprah, and they raised 9 kids on their own, so by themselves. And their quote says, "Everyone, particularly every child, needs an identity larger than himself, something he or she belongs to, feels part of, and gains security and protection from. It is kids who do not get this identity from their families who are drawn to the rituals, colors, traditions of gangs, or other identity substitutes for families." So as I think of that, I think of some of the traditions in my family. We have unique fundraisers. We take Atlantic City bus rides, raffles. The biggest earner would probably be the dinner sales we had. And how those work is, we just basically, the family creates a menu, everyone's responsible for a dish. We pass them out around the neighborhood and the surrounding businesses. I remember 1 year I had to be about 8, and I remember me and my father going to make a delivery to the airport. And I remember it was like 40 dinners. Those are usually our biggest like customers, the airport. And then another tradition would be family meetings. And we've all heard the saying, it takes money to raise money. So what we do is we have family dues, and everyone has to contribute to the family fund. And I mean everyone, no one's excluded. As you can see, ages 1 through 6, they have to give 25 cents. You know, ages 7 through 11, $1, and so on and so forth. And then at the end, every summer we go on a family trip. And coming from my family, we weren't really rich, we didn't have much, but thanks to the traditions, I was able to go to some pretty awesome places like Disney World and, you know, the Grand Canyon and places like that. Now, obviously it takes a lot, you know, to keep these traditions up. A lot of responsibility is involved. And I think that the elders in our family do a good job of handing out the responsibility to other family members. And I found this interesting article, and it's by Jay Valori, and it's titled Empowerment to the People. It says, empowerment gives employees the feeling of belonging, allowing them to feel pride in their work and to take ownership of their tasks. Now, what I found was that I adopted some of these same feelings of pride when I was given responsibility in a family setting. Some examples of this would be Thanksgiving. Well, we don't have just traditional dishes because there's so many of us. So everyone's responsible for a dish, and there's only so many traditional Thanksgiving dishes. So some people will be in charge of lasagna, which is not really a traditional dish. One year, I think I was a sophomore in high school, and they told me I would be working on a banana pudding. I've never done it before, you know, and then I made it and everyone loved it. And until this day, you know, I'm still responsible for banana pudding every Thanksgiving. And then also the 4th of July cookout, which was my junior year in high school. And I had to man the grill, and I'm talking a big family. So there was 2 big, you know, grill pits. We got burgers, hot dogs, ribs, chicken, everything. And I'm just burning up, it's hot. But everyone told me what a great job I did, and I felt a sense of pride. Next is proximity. Obviously, it's easier to hold people accountable and to communicate expectations when people are living close together. Now, in my family, a lot has changed since, you know, I was younger. Growing up, the majority of my family lived in a 5-block radius. So like I could literally walk from one aunt's house to an uncle's house to another uncle's house without breaking a sweat. But in the middle of everything was, you know, this one central meeting location, which was my grandmother's house. And that's the place where all of our traditions, you know, were carried out. But like I said, things have changed. Some people have moved away. I still have a lot of family in that area, but a few people move. So according to an article titled, The Family and Communication technologies are increasingly being used within family settings to support extended relationships. So now with the families who moved away, you know, Skype plays a major part. They can attend meetings, you know, via Skype. Even if they're not home, they could Skype on their iPhone or anything like that. Even the way they pay their dues has changed. Traditionally, you would just, you know, submit a check in the mail. That takes time. But now with, you know, just electronic bank transfer, you could open up the laptop and you can see who paid what. And that's really a great tool. And then in conclusion, I interviewed Dr. Ann Law, and she's the psychology chair here at Rider. And also she's the specialist on child development here at Rider. And she said two of the major benefits to having a strong family connection are being able to share resources and being able to have that emotional connection. And I feel like that I've had these two benefits due to the strong family connection that was created through the tradition, the responsibility, and proximity that I was given in my family.